Actually, you've really made very strong recommendations today on how to move forward. But let me take you first on the last three that you've mentioned before I go to the international, before I go to the ICJ or that you've mentioned. It's the International Tribunal for the Law of the Sea, which is going back to ITLOS, essentially. Okay, number one is the practical advice of leaving BRP Sierra Madre there in Ayungin Shoal, but then putting up a lighthouse manned by the Coast Guard. And would you say putting up another vessel that is manned by the Coast Guard and do the resupply mission to the Coast Guard?
Yes, we keep Sierra Madre there. We still continue to supply by airdrop or
Yeah.
helicopter drop, but we should have a civilian facility there
Yeah.
so that we have a tribunal to go to. So
Uh-oh.
they will coexist until we finish the Coast Guard substation. We can give up
Yeah.
the Sierra Madre already because that's really going to collapse anytime.
Uh-oh. I think practically that's a brilliant suggestion. Honestly speaking, it's practical. It doesn't hurt anyone, and it reinforces our stand in our exclusive economic zone with a tribunal to run to. So that's one. Number two, you said, is the Philippines joining Malaysia and Vietnam in going to court for the extended continental shelf, right?
That's
Why
right.
aren't we joining Malaysia and Vietnam when it could be honestly a joint advocacy of three countries to get together and solidify claims, right? Why isn't the Philippines doing that?
Well, before when the Malaysians and the Vietnamese offered the invited us to submit it to voluntary arbitration a few years ago during the time of President Aquino. There were some people in the DFA that thought that we will compromise our Sabah claim because our Sabah claim included a coastline facing the South China Sea. But this has been settled definitively and officially by the UP Law Center. UP Law Center issued an opinion that our Sabah claim, the territory of the Sultan of Sulu in Sabah, never faced the South China Sea. It faced the Sulu Sea and the Celebes Sea. So we do not compromise anything. So it's time to move on. It's
Yeah,
time to go to the next step
agree.
because we are allowing China to use the time to harass us. So let us be. Let's go on the offensive, but legally. And
Yeah.
this is a very good opportunity because the three countries, we're not talking about territory here. We're talking about maritime zones beyond the exclusive economic zone. Because when Vietnam and Malaysia invited us to negotiate the overlapping extended continental shelf, they impliedly admit that they accept our exclusive economic zone in the West Philippine Sea, because the extended continental shelf will start from the edge of the exclusive economic zone. They said, okay, the exclusive economic zone in that area is yours. But beyond that, there is an extended continental shelf that overlap with ours. So let's negotiate so that we'll fix it.
Yeah.
And that will isolate China because China will never want to join that arbitration. And so the arbitral tribunal will still examine whether there is another country that has a claim there because China has officially objected. Remember, when we just filed recently our extended continental shelf claim, China objected. So now China will be in a dilemma. They objected. So we asked them, okay, join us in this arbitration because you have an objection. But they will not appear because they know they will lose. So they will be in a dilemma.
And then another recommendation you made, which is quite practical, and it would show that the Philippines is proactively fighting for its rights within the exclusive economic zone, is ITLOS, to actually draw up rules when it comes to Scarborough Shoal. But can ITLOS really draw up rules in terms of, fishing for the three countries in yes. Scarborough Shoal? Does that cover? Do they have jurisdiction to do that? That's almost like an IRR.
Yes, because the tribunal already said it's a common fishing ground. And with that decision, the three countries should have come to, should have negotiated what are the common rules, because you cannot just allow one country to fish, to get all the fish there. So you must decide how many tons each country is entitled and what are the seasons for fishing, because you have to allow the fish to regenerate. There must be an off-season year. So the tribunal expected the three countries to come together and discuss that. But of course, China will not agree. Yeah. So what we will do is we will come out with our proposed common rules. We'll send it to China, to Vietnam, and ask them to sit down. Vietnam will agree, but China will not. So when China refuses, then we go to the tribunal. And that tribunal has a duty to resolve that issue because it has jurisdiction.
Okay, so I think these three points on going back to the International Tribunal for the Law of the Sea, they're very strong. My question is, during the time of the late President Aquino, he formed a team, right? And now we have President Marcos Jr., who's made this his advocacy. He stood by the victory. But is there right now a team in Malacañang where you see that this actually could come into fruition? Well, do you have a co-advocate, kumbaga Justice Carpio? Do you have an advocate in Malacañang that actually sees you eye to eye on this?
I have discussed this publicly and in my public lectures. They know about this. But it's really time to consider this because we have no other recourse. We've thought about this when China seized Scarborough Shoal in 2012. We came to the conclusion we cannot use force because if we use force, we will lose. We will lose if we fight China in the sea. We will only win if we fight China in a court of law where warplanes, warships, missiles do not count. Where the decision will be based solely on the facts and the law. And we are very strong there. That's why we should exploit that. We should use that as our primary defense.
Mm-mm. And would you say, actually, it actually even helps President Marcos Jr. with his advocacy on the West Philippine Sea? It helps him, his administration, his own legacy. Right.
That's correct, Karen, because in his latest statement, he said, we will not use force.
Yeah.
We will resolve this peacefully. And that means going to court, because going to court means peaceful resolution of this issue. That's in the UN Charter. Peaceful resolution means negotiation, mediation, and finally arbitration. And we will do that. We are at that stage already. So if the president says we will resort to a peaceful resolution, it has to be by arbitration. There's no other way.
Okay. My other question now is, this is different from your recommendations of going back to the International Tribunal for the Law of the Sea, or ITLOS, is you did suggest that the incident in Ayungin Shoal be brought to the International Court of Justice. Tama ito, sir. Tama rinig ko, no?
Yes. We will, not only the Ayungin Shoal incident, but the entire territorial dispute.
Okay.
Because the UN Charter says all disputes must be settled by peaceful means, by negotiation, mediation, and finally by arbitration. Let us challenge China, officially and publicly, that we want to settle this peacefully in accordance with the UN Charter. And we are asking China to submit this territorial dispute, the entire territorial dispute, to arbitration by International Court of Justice.
Yeah.
And then the world will know whether China follows the rule of law or not.
Mm-mm. You make a strong point in the sense that when the president said, we will not use force, And then you say the only way is to go legal again, because we always win, right? Because at the end of the day, when you go legal, when you are right, you win. But do you believe, this is my last question, that it will worsen the diplomatic ties between the Philippines and China if we choose to go back to ITLOS or go to the ICJ for, let's say, those territorial disputes? Because the relationship between the Philippines and China isn't just about the West Philippine Sea. We also have issues on trade, people-to-people relations. What do you think, sir?
Karen, the alternative is we don't go to in an international tribunal. And the alternative is we have to fight China in the sea. And that will really worsen everything. That could create, that could instigate a war in the sea. And we don't want that. Mm-mm. And there's no other way. If we don't go to court, we have to defend it in the sea. We cannot win there because China is the largest navy in the world, the largest coast guard in the world, the largest submarine force in the world, the largest standing army in the world. We will be crazy to go to that arena. That battleground, we have no chance of winning there. Let's go to the legal, to the court of justice, where we are strong on the facts and the law.
On that note, I want to thank you for joining me today, former Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio. You've made practical and actually reachable, reasonable, doable recommendations for the Philippines today. Thank you so much, sir. It's wonderful to have you back.
Thank you, Karen, for having me. Thank you to our viewers.